It's Thursday, November the 10th, 2016, and this is your Barbados Today Evening Update. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Thanks for joining us. We begin with news that industrial action called by the National Union of Public Workers will be intensified tomorrow with the call-out of all immigration and customs officers. The decision was reached this afternoon following a major meeting which the NUPW held with the leadership of all trade unions in Barbados to consolidate a strategy in support of demands for the reinstatement of Akani McDowell to the acting senior position from which he was removed within the Ministry of Health. A senior union official told Barbados Today that immigration and customs officers will be meeting at NUPW headquarters tomorrow afternoon, and industrial action will continue over the weekend at the island's ports of entry. The official said if the union does not get a satisfactory response from the Personnel Administration Division on Monday regarding its demands for McDowell's reinstatement, the various unions will also be calling out their various members to meetings next week as well. The official revealed that the visit here later this month by Prince Harry of England for independence celebrations could also be affected, particularly if a scheduled meeting with the airport management for Monday regarding salaries does not come off. Police are continuing investigations into the stabbing of Fernando Holder of Maxwell Christ Church. Holder sustained injuries to his left jaw and left arm. He was treated at the Queen Elizabeth Hospital and discharged. The stabbing occurred during a dispute with a woman. Meanwhile, a 30-year-old man, Jason Farley of French Village St. Peter, is receiving medical attention after sustaining multiple facial fractures in a road accident early this morning. Farley reportedly lost control of his car while driving along Prospect Main Road in St. James and slammed into a utility pole. Barbados will soon have that long-promised community early warning system in place to help citizens escape any pending natural disasters such as a tsunami. The disclosure came today from Acting Director of the Department of Emergency Management, Kerry Hines, during a tsunami preparedness exercise at Martins Bay in St. John.
It is hoped that we will have also the early warning system in place so that people can react and they can take themselves to safety if in fact something actually occurs. So it is an ongoing effort from our end at the department, and we hope that people will capitalize on the efforts and go forward and internalize all the information, because at the end of the day, we're trying to preach a culture, instill a culture of safety to all our residents.
Government will shortly examine ways on how power can be restored to businesses and homes whose renewable energy systems are abandoned or destroyed during a hurricane or storm. Speaking at a panel discussion during the inaugural Caribbean Sustainable Energy Independence Conference at the Lloyd Erskine Sandiford Center this morning, Minister responsible for Energy, Senator Darcy Boyce, said this is an area to which serious attention must be given.
And that is something I will have to drive the power company and to all our people to look at very seriously, because we need to run some simulations. We need to look at what self-insurance we need to take and what steps we have to take in the event of that renewable energy system being impacted, or what backup plan we need to have in the event of a storm destroying some of that renewable energy plant. It's not a problem that I think can't be solved. I think, and I feel very sure that we can solve that problem, but I think we need to face it head on and know what it is we're getting, how we are going to deal with these situations, not if they happen, but when they're in time.
Senator Boyce also announced plans to change out all of the non-energy saving lights across Barbados over a five-year period. He said his ministry will be working with Emera, that's the parent company of the Barbados Light and Power Company, which has done a similar project in Canada.
And I'm going to challenge them to find a way to help us do the same thing here in Barbados, and to work with us and the financing agencies to see how we can do that. Think what that, the difference that would make. I mean, you know, all the street lights, and then also, you know, all of the incandescents in see ourselves, and we can do that, say, within 5 years. It was going to make a significant impact on our use of foreign exchange.
The Salvation Army today reported encouraging signs for the continuation of its varied charity work, including the feeding of more than 4,000 needy people per month. But addressing the official launch of its annual Christmas kettle appeal in Jubilee Gardens, the city, Divisional Commander Sinus Theodore lamented that the Meals on Wheels program was being impeded due to its truck that has outlived its usefulness.
And we don't want that. We are taking meals to our people and the vehicle breaks down and they cannot get the meals. But I know that you are very generous and you hear us calling, making an appeal. I am sure that someone, somewhere, even if you don't afford to give it personally, you may contact somebody, say, I know there are two great needs at the Salvation Army. They need a truck for their thrift store to pick up items from people when they call, and also a vehicle to help transporting the food to those who need it. And those goes to people who cannot come to the feeding program. We have to deliver the service home to them.
There's regional and international news after this short break.
Read all about it, read all about it. Get your paper, only 225. Let's get your paper.
You again with that stale news from yesterday. I got the Barbados today app on my phone, and I just get my news for free.
What do she?
The Barbados Today, news you can trust.
Public Bank, just like Santa Claus. Maisie fix up the kitchen, and a new TV we get in. A special time to commemorate. Republic will help you celebrate.
Get ready to celebrate 50 years of independence right through to the best Bajan Christmas ever with a Make It Happen loan of up to $50,000 from Republic Bank. Give your home a good old Bajan spruce up. Buy some new furniture and appliances, or take an after holiday trip to visit loved ones over and away. You could also be one of our lucky winners to share in fabulous prizes. Just visit any branch to apply. Go to RepublicBarbados.com or call us at 227-2700. We're also available via Skype and FaceTime. Special conditions apply.
Republic Bank, we're the one for you.
Welcome back with news from the region now. Health authorities in Guyana are this week introducing another birth control option for women.
Another option in the line of contraceptives is being made available for females. It is a thin, flexible plastic implant about the size of a matchstick. It is designed to be inserted under the skin of the upper arm to protect against pregnancy for up to 5 years. Here's Maternal and Child Health Officer, Ministry of Public Health, Dr. Artenisia Hamilton.
The contraceptive that we'll be introducing is the implant. And it's referred to in medical terminology as one of the long-acting reversible contraceptives. And reversible means that at any point in time when you choose, if you would like it removed, it can be removed, and the actual effects that it will have will be reversed.
And on the international scene, President Barack Obama welcomed President-elect Donald Trump to the White House today, as both men put past antagonisms aside in a time-honored ritual epitomizing the peaceful transfer of political power.
Well, I just had the opportunity to have an excellent conversation with President-elect Trump. It was wide-ranging. We talked about some of the organizational issues in setting up a White House. We talked about foreign policy. We talked about domestic policy. And as I said last night, my number one priority in the coming 2 months is to try to facilitate a transition that ensures our president-elect is successful.
We discussed a lot of different situations, some wonderful and some difficulties. I very much look forward to dealing with the president in the future, including counsel. He explained some of the difficulties, some of the high-flying assets, and some of the really great things that have been achieved. So, Mr. President, it was a great honor being with you, and I look forward to being with you many, many more times in the future. Thank you.
That's news, but for the very latest, visit our website at www.barbadostoday.bb. Also subscribe to our e-paper email updates and like us on Facebook. We are also on Izumi Media in bus terminals, our screenplay at supermarkets and gas stations near you, as well as Channel 99 on Flow TV and Mix 96.9 FM. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Have a fantastic evening.